गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑल इन ऑनलाइन क्लासेज फॉर सोशल साइंस चैप्टर द राइज ऑफ स्मॉल किंगडम्स इन नॉर्थ इंडिया इज गोइंग ऑन एंड टूडे आई विल डिस्कस थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर दैट इज ट्राइपार्टाइट स्ट्रगल. स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड in details about the age of three empire. These three powerful kingdoms arose between 750 CE to 1000 CE out of the ruins of Harsaj empire. The Rashtrakutas took over the control in northern part of Deccan, the Pals in Eastern India, that is Bengal and Bihar region, and the Pratiharas in Avanti, southern Rajasthan and Gujarat. The three main kingdoms, though continuously engaged in wars, were successful in providing stable administrations which helped in progress of art and literature. We have already discussed in previous video that the Rashtrakutas established the most powerful empire in northern Deccan in 753 CE. They became the master of a large area of the present Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, Maharashtra and Karnataka. Their empire acted as a bridge between North and South India. Danti Durg is considered to be the real founder of the Rashtrakutas empire. Govind III and Amod Varsha, the period between 814 to 880 CE, were the well-known Rashtrakutas king. They were great warriors, art lovers and scholars. They maintained huge armies and encouraged trade for the prosperity of the people. They took up titles like Chakravarti, Maharaja Dhiraj and Padam Bhattada. Students, let's we know about the brief about Pals so that we can easily understand the tripartite struggle. Pals in previous video that very limited information is available about the history of Bengal for the period between the death of Harsha and the ascending of Pals. But it is well known that during this time, the Bengal faced a lot of infighting among small kingdoms. The people of Bengal elected Gopal as their king to maintain peace and order. He set up an empire which ruled over for about 400 years, and Dharmpal was the greatest ruler of this dynasty. He set up a center of Buddhist education which was known as Vikramsil Vihar. You can see in this picture also. After that we will discuss about the Pratihara in brief. They are also called Gurjar Pratihar, probably because they originated from Gujarat. They ruled over Gujarat and southwestern Rajasthan.
द फाउंडर ऑफ प्रतिहारा एम्पायर वॉज नागवर्त वन एंड द ग्रेटेस्ट रूलर ऑफ दिस डायनेस्टी वॉज मिहिर भोज एंड ही कॉन्क्वर्ड कन्नौज अराउंड 836 CE. Now, till here you understood about these three dynasties, and I have already discussed with you in previous class that these all three dynasties fought each other to control over each other's land. Now, let us discuss the tripartite struggles. The ruler belonging to the Gurjar Pratihara, Pala and Rashtrakutas dynasty often fought each other to control over Kannauj. Why they fought each other to control over Kannauj? Kannauj was then a symbol of sovereignty. You can easily understand through this map. It was well situated in the northern plains. Therefore, whoever captured Kannauj could control the Ganga Valley. Their struggle for supremacy was known as the tripartite struggle. These three kingdoms were almost equal in strength. So, the victory of one king over the other didn't last very long. Students, I repeat again that these three kingdoms were almost equal in strength. So, the victory of one king over the other didn't last very long. These three kingdoms were so busy in fighting among themselves that they didn't realize how weak that had all became. Around the end of 10th century CE, these powerful declines almost simultaneously. Other dynasties came into existence over their territories. Most of these were Rajput. Now, students, through some questions, again we will discuss today's topic in brief. First one is define tripartite struggle. What was tripartite struggle? The three kingdoms that are the Rashtrakutas, the Pal and the Pratiharas were continuously engaged in a struggle to possess or Kannauj. Their struggle for supremacy was known as the tripartite struggles. And my next question is, mention any five important features of the Rashtrakuta Empire. Five features of Rashtrakuta Empire were as under. How you will write? In this way you will write, and you have to write in a point wise. First important point which you write about the Rashtrakutas. Rashtrakutas were great warriors, art lovers and scholars. I have already discussed about this topic. Now second point is, you can write, they took up titles like Chakravarti, Maharaja Dhiraj and Param Bhattarak. Third point is, they maintained huge armies and encouraged trade for the prosperity of the people. Fourth point, you can write, Rashtrakutas followed Jainism but also patronized Buddhist, Hindus and Muslims. And you can write in fifth point, they were great patrons of art and learning. Rock cut temples of Alora belonging to Hindu, Buddhist and Jain sects are a proof of the religious tolerance of Rashtrakutas. These are important points you can write. Next question is, what is the contribution of Pallas dynasty? In this question you can write, the contribution of Pallas dynasty is where as under. Again you have to write in points. The Pallas rulers were the followers of Buddhism. Many scholars were sent to distant countries to spread Buddhism. Now you can write, Dhampal set up a center for Buddhist education which was known as Vikramsil Vihar. They also gave generous grants to Brahmins to build temples. Pallas were the great patron of art, educations and literatures. And you can write in last point, the famous Nalanda University was revived during the Pallas empires. That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.